just arrived here in Shanghai, and it's pretty cool. About to go through customs and then head to the hotel. So I'm gonna show you guys how the hotel looks and everything. But it's definitely different.
How you doing?
Good, good.
A few moments later.
Just got to the hotel room and just check this out. It's super nice. Let me show you guys the view outside. I think I'm gonna be getting dinner right across over there in about an hour, and then I think that's like where people live. It's a pretty cool city so far. I'm really excited to explore it and, you know, see how everything is. But this bathroom looks really cool. Look at it. It's a really nice hotel. Shout out to BPI for hooking it up. I got all these samples that I'll be taking to the expo tomorrow that I packed. But yeah, just want to give you guys an idea on, like, you know, how the room is here in Shanghai. It's really upscale. I love it here. But I'm just gonna rest up. I was just on like a 14-hour flight. It was pretty brutal. Just gonna rest up. I think back at home it's like 4 a.m. and it's 4 p.m. here right now, so I might have to get used to the time zone. But I'll keep you guys updated with, you know, how the whole entire trip will be.
Alright guys, second day here in China. I just ate dinner, had a pie, pizza, pretty much my cheat meal. It's really good. Good Italian food. And check out the view that we have here.
Tallest building today's closed due to a typhoon.
Oh really?
So we are going to like a second tallest one.
Okay. When we go to this tall building, what are we gonna be able to see outside?
You can see the outside from inside. But you will now be outdoor.
Okay.
But I don't know why they closed that.
Yeah.
Maybe it's too high and it's waving.
I'm excited to check it out.
Yeah. And the car is coming.
1, 2, 3. Feel kind of tired from the jet lag. Wow, look at that Ferrari. Fell asleep on the way here for like 30 minutes.
Is there like a lot of good places here?
Food?
Yeah.
Yeah, of course.
Japanese, all kind of food.
I see the Apple Store over there.
Yeah, Apple Store, yeah.
Yeah, I never really explored much. Only got I went to get deep dish pizza one time after my show, but I was just there just for the show. Like I was just at the one hotel and just there. Yeah.
So this area in Shanghai is similar to the center of Chicago.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Do you have like vodka here? They have sriracha in there?
Sriracha.
That's a bomb.
So when you go in there, do you go all the way to the top?
Or I think go up like there, like the small ball.
How about like those boats? Where are they for? Are those like cruises?
Yeah, some of these are cruises. Some of it's just for transportation, you know, from this side to the other side.
Yeah. Wow. It's nicer.
Today is a Chinese version of Valentine's
Day. Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
Okay. So people go on dates and stuff.
Do you want to say to your girlfriend?
Wish she was here right now. It'd be a cool time to get a drink or something.
Tastes like a peach, but like kind of like an orange too, a little bit or something.
I think this trip is just basically just around the expo.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, yeah, right.
Cause like I remember when my mom used to go to like Vietnam, she'll stay there for like 2 months, or a month or something like that.
You need some time to like to explore more about the culture, about the city, about the country. Like a couple of days is not long enough.
Yeah. So do people here still listen to American music? Like,
like we listen to Billboards.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, we listen to iTunes.
Okay.
All the
So actually, basically all the culture from US, Chinese people can accept that. I'm not saying everybody should do bodybuilding, but everybody should work out.
Just have goals to reach.
You don't have to step on the stage. Right.
Exactly, you know? Exactly.
You can be on stage. It's a it's a ultimate goal. It's good to go. But also you can work out just for healthy.
Yeah, just to be better. I have friends that, you know, I have friends that I went to high school with, and they will go to the gym with me, but like they would never pursue to be a competitive bodybuilder, but they would go to the gym because it would feel good. It's kind of like a therapy, you know,
right.
If you have a lot of stress, you go to the gym, like, you know, it's just like therapy.
So the slogan of our company is to be a better yourself. So you can always be better and be better.
That's true. Yeah. It's at the end of the day, you know, everyone's their own person. You can't really sit there and compare yourself to like, I can't sit here and be like, oh, like, I want to look like Jerry Buendia, or like, he's his own person at the end of the day.
Right.
Everybody's their own person, so everyone is unique in their own way, you know? Like, I might be good at bodybuilding, but if I try to do something with the computer or whatever, like, I wouldn't be that great at that, you know?
Yeah.
So everyone has their own niche. At first, my stuff was just like so simple. It's still simple, but I make it work, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, I'm not one to make it super, like, you know, drones, like, flying around. That's just, like...
That's debilitating.
Just
debilitating.
Yeah, it's just not my style to do. It's really cool how he's so, He's just as passionate with editing videos and stuff as he is with training, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, for me, like, when I edit videos, like, when I do shows, like, obviously I get tired, but I don't sit there and be like, oh, I gotta do this. I get kind of fascinated putting together videos, and when it all flows together, it looks pretty cool, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I can't imagine how David feels when he's like, dude, if you watch his most recent video, it just looks like super professional. Like, it's crazy how...
Movie director.
Yeah, I told him, I was like, you should get involved in like Hollywood one day, you know? Alright guys, right now we're waiting for an Uber and we're about to head to a massage place. I'm about to get a foot massage. I've never actually got a foot massage before. I've got my nails done with my girlfriend before, and they like touched my foot. It felt kind of like ticklish, but I've never actually had like a full-on foot massage, so I'm really excited to experience it and see how it is, and we'll see how it goes.
It's been 20 years. Yeah.
month?
No.
Once a month.
Steven, you can tell if it hurts.
Yeah. Really?
You can let him know if it hurts.
你问他这个力道可以吗?
Is this too soft or too heavy? That's fine.
Feels fine.
那力道不合适的话说一下。
I think there's a spot in my back though that always hits tight, which is like in the upper right corner.
Yeah.
右侧。But right now it feels fine.
How do you feel?
Feels really sensitive since it's like my first time getting it done. But it does feel kind of relaxing.
Yeah.
Got the foot massage done and the experience was pretty good. It was really relaxing. But there's certain parts where it made me kind of jump and I was kind of ticklish, but overall it's a really good experience. So if you guys ever do go to China, definitely get a foot massage.
All right, day three here at the FIBO. Check out all the people that came out to see me.
Pretty exhausted, but all I gotta say is the fans from China are awesome. You know, everyone is so friendly and cool. Like, I had such an amazing time there, and it's just crazy how, like, there's so many people here that actually know me, you know, and I have never been here before, so I think that's absolutely insane. So, you know, I'm very grateful to be able to come out here and meet everyone. Now I'm just gonna rest up a little bit, then eat a pre-workout meal, and then go to the gym. I'm excited to, you know, get a workout in and also to see how the gyms are here. So I'm just gonna rest up a little bit, eat my pre-workout meal, and then go to the gym. So I think I'm gonna train some shoulders and, you know, I'll get some footage of that, show you guys my workout.
All right guys, we just wrapped up the expo. You know, it's crazy to come out here and know that there's so many fans here in China. So, you know, I had a great time at the expo. Now I'm about to train shoulders with China's newest IFBB Pro. About to train some shoulders. We're gonna warm up our rotator cuff first and then hit some dumbbell shoulder presses. Gonna shoot for a total of 4 working heavy sets. We'll see how I feel. Today, basically, I've been working, you know, the expo the whole time, and so I feel kind of tired, but I did take pre-workout, so we'll see how I feel.
Doing the shit that I do, riding around with the crew. Ring up your name, we like who? We don't know shit that you do. Never had nothing to prove. Why you out caught in the loop? I'm smoking with nothing to lose. Bitch, I'm the truth, all this is the proof. Making money, countless paper. Living so life, fuckers are major. Making money, countless paper. Nobody touch me, I don't do nothing. Don't got me lazy. What got me lazy? Doing the shit that I do. Riding around with the crew. Bring up your name, we like who? We don't know shit that you do. Never had nothing to prove. Why you are caught in the loop? I'm smoking with nothing to lose. Bitch, I'm the truth of the city to prove. Made me money. Countless paper, baby. Living so love, fuck is a major, baby. Making me money, countless paper, baby. Nobody touch me, I don't need nothing, don't got me lazy.
We just got to this place, I think it's called the Hot Pot. Basically, you get your beef and you dip it in the pot, which is boiling water, and then you eat it with, like, you know, rice or noodles. I got rice. I'm really excited to try this out. I never tried it before, and we'll show you guys the food when it comes out. So if you're a bodybuilder here, this is a good spot to go eat.
Yeah.
Even during
for
a
sure,
pattern.
For sure, for sure.
Is that the same beef they put in pho?
No. I think this one, yes.
This is steak level.
Okay.
Like salon.
Yeah, salon. This one is like salon. And this one is really like...
This one is very lean.
Very lean.
Very lean.
And that's beef tongue.
But this one is more tender.
So take the beef and dip into the sauce. It's good.
Yeah, it's really good.
Finished up the third day, my final day here in China, and all I gotta say is China is such an amazing place, from the food to the people. Right now we're at a traditional place right now here, and everything just looks really different, but I like the design because back over there is like the newer modern parts of China, but this is like the traditional. But it's really populated, there's a lot of people, but there's so many places and things to do here, so I think it would be a good place to go check out if you were to go on vacation or just to know more about China. Hope you guys all enjoy this video. I want to give a huge shout out for BPI for giving me the opportunity to come out here, and also huge shout out to Change Pro, the app, for, you know, taking care of me while I'm here in China. They gave me such a good experience, and I'm very thankful that they were here to help me.